Let's see if we can better understand what a cash flow statement for my simplified shipping truck example company, what it would actually look like. And I say it's simplified because this is a very simplified income statement for each of these periods. I'm not really showing all of the expenses and all of the details that you would actually have for a shipping company, but we really just care about the accounting. So let's just say at the beginning of this fiscal year, when I started this company, I had $60,000. We know from our example that we used that $60,000 to buy a $60,000 truck. And on the cash flow statement, you express that saying, I spent $60,000 on capital expenditures. Sometimes it's property, plant, and equipment. And so you would actually put the $60,000 right over here on capital expenditures. And hopefully we'll understand this a little bit. And remember, the cash flow statement is really a way of reconciling the profit with the starting and the ending cash. So let's just think about this a little bit. Our profit here, if we just take the number that we have right over here, our profit in the first period is $30,000. We're assuming nothing shady is happening with the accounts payables, accounts receivables, that they're not changing over the course of the year. And then we have the depreciation. And we want to think a little bit in this video, what does the depreciation do to the cash flow statement? So I'll just write down the number first. So we have this depreciation value. This is the truck depreciation now. It's not just the expensed value of the truck. We're spreading that cost over 3 years. So 20,000 over 3 years is the life of that truck. So the depreciation each of these periods is 20. And what I'm going to show you here is to figure out the cash from operations, from actually what is the how much cash is the, are the operations producing, we want to add back. We want to add back this depreciation to the profit. So our cash from operations is going to be $50,000. And it might not seem obvious to you at first, but I want you to think about it. This $20,000 that we're showing as an expense in every period, and actually might be a little bit more obvious if we think about period two or period three. We're showing it as an expense, but no, $20,000 did not go out of the door in year two or year three. We're just showing some of the expense from previous years. So no cash went out of the door. So in any of these periods, the depreciation expense should be added back to the operating profit to figure out the cash from operations. And you might say, wait, but we spent that $60,000, especially in year one. And that here goes under capital expenditures. That wasn't somehow, the operations didn't push that cash out. The business itself, this was just an investment that we made. So it all works out because what we see is we got $50,000 cash from operations. And that makes sense because our revenue was $100,000. Just the labor, the cash labor, people's salaries were $50,000. So that's $50,000 of profit. This was not a cash expense. So from our operations, we had $50,000. But then we did have the capital expenditures of $60,000 for the actual truck. So our ending cash would be 60 plus 50 minus 60. So our ending cash is going to be $50,000. Now it might make a little bit more sense if we go to the next period. Our starting cash here is $50,000. It's our ending cash of the previous period. Our profit, once again, is $30,000. You add the profit to the depreciation. You get a $50,000 operating profit, same as the previous year, or I should say cash from operations. And that makes sense, because our operations really haven't changed. We have a very, very steady business. But this year, I have no capital expenditures. I'm using the same trucks from last year. So now our ending cash, our starting cash was 50. We have 50,000 from operations. Now our ending cash is $100,000. So hopefully that gives you a sense of how of why we add back depreciation when we figure out the cash from operations and how it works out in our cash flow statement.